my name is Steve Smith, and I'm with Forterra Pressure Pipe. What I want to talk to you about today is two pipe products, pre-stressed concrete cylinder pipe, which is we're looking at right here. Pre-stressed concrete cylinder pipe, what you see here is you can see the pre-stressing wire. This is 6-gauge wire, class 3. It's got a tensile range of 252,000 to 282,000. You'll notice that the spacing between the wires, that term today is called the pitch of the wire, means the spacing between rod wrap to rod wrap. For instance, this looks like it could be like a 1-inch pitch. You'll notice the mortar coating. The mortar coating is one inch over top of the cylinder. Okay. What we're going to transition to now, I want to show you the difference between the pre-stressed pipe and what is known as the bar wrap pipe. Okay, we're going to select. This is bar wrap pipe. To the naked eye, one might say they look exactly the same, but you're going to notice this is rod. It's not pre-stressing wire. It's rod. Wrapped at about 500 PSI, in which it's got a heavy steel cylinder, which differs from the pre-stressed concrete cylinder pipe, which only has a 16-gauge cylinder.
What's the pressure rating for the bar wrap?
The bar wrap
for like water pressure rating?
Bar wrap pipe is rated, you know, typically zero all the way up to 250 PSI.
Just like the pre-stress.
Very similar to pre-stress.
Okay.
The key difference is bar wrap pipe is a semi-rigid design.
Okay.
Semi-flexible, if you will, versus pre-stress, which is a rigid design. So bar wrap pipe does rely on soil side support, much more important than, say, pre-stress. What this demonstrates here is the ability to be able to chip out the mortar coating.
Right.
Take the rod wraps and basically cut them and bend them out of your way. And this shows the application where we can actually weld a flange in the field.
This is kind of almost like called a weld-a-lead, is that correct? Is that what this would be called?
I'm not familiar with the term. But what makes bar wrap unique, unlike pre-stress,
right,
is pre-stress, because of the wire wraps, you basically can't cut this pipe and make any modifications because of the wire is under tension. Versus this pipe, because the rod is not under tension, this is a steel pipe design, it gives you the ability to cut section this type of bar wrap pipe. If we go to the other side, I'll show you some other examples. What you're looking at here is bar wrap pipe. Notice the rod. What this demonstrates is the ability to take, say, a 20-foot section of bar wrap pipe. You can literally cut the pipe in half. What you see here, you take the rod wraps and just peel a couple rods back, and what this shows, the ability to weld a flange in the field with the butt strap. That's something, quite frankly, that you could not do with a pre-stressed concrete cylinder pipe. So when it comes to adaptability and repairability in the field, bar wrap has become a favorite choice here in the East. Okay. This just demonstrates a harness clamp joint. This is a harness style joint that's been around for many, many years. This is one form of restraint joint. If we go back over here to the left, obviously this demonstrates our snap ring joint. This is a snap ring joint. It's a joint, it was a Price Brothers design joint back in the early 70s, it's 1973, and it's a joint ring we still use today. If we jump to the other side, you just see this is the insert. It basically allows the contractor to push the spigot into the bell. You simply tighten down, loosen a nut and tighten down this bolt. And what the term we use, now the snap ring is engaged, means it's locked down. As you can see in this cutout section, you can see where it, because it's a smaller diameter, how it locks in the spigot ring and keeps it from backing out under thrust conditions.
Thanks.
You're welcome.
Steve, I really appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.